Assalamu alaikum students, moving forward to concept number 3. It's a continuation lecture video of the previous, the question that we were doing, that is S2 linear combinations of random variable chapter. We need to understand that previously we have discussed some of independent observations that are mostly coming in the exam paper questions in two parts. So part A, you have to add for the mean and variance, that is the sum of independent observations. And for part B, this is basically the multiple concept that they're asking. And the hint is basically twice and thrice, where you have to square for the variance as well. Okay, where you will have to square for the variance. So let's start discussing about this concept number 3, that is the multiple concept. Okay, if you are having, there is multiple observations and then there is the sum of independent observations. So we have already discussed sum of independent observations. We'll do more examples on that, but we are discussing now the multiple observations when you have to multiply and those things. So the hint is basically twice and thrice the word being used as well. So we have to find the probability that the volume of juice in a randomly chosen large bottle. So first thing, write this down, that the randomly chosen large bottle will be L. It is at least twice. It is at least means minimum, kamaskam. It is at least twice the volume of juice in a randomly chosen small bottle. So here we go. This will be 2 times of S. So what they are saying, that whatever the volume of juice in the large bottle is there, it should be to greater than 2 times of the small bottle. So L is greater than equals to 2S, or L is more than 2S. Okay, that's what you can say. Twice means here's 2, okay, and that is why this will give an impression that this is going to be multiply and square as well, because this is a multiple here, okay, students. So how do you deal this with this? It's going to be that you bring it, always remember in this type of question, you bring it to the other side, on the left hand side. So it will be L minus 2S is greater than equals to 0, okay, students, greater than equals to 0, or you can write just greater than as well, it doesn't matter much here, okay. So L minus 2S is greater than equals to 0, so here we go, it is going to be L minus 2S, let's use the word of here as Y, okay. So Y is basically our normal distribution going to be, students, and we have L minus 2S, we'll have to take information from the previous question again. So let's use calculator. And again, as I said, that from the 5 marks, 2-3 marks are for the mean and variance finding out, and the remaining 2 marks, 2.5 marks, 3 marks are for solving of the normal distribution question, okay. So again, this is same, that large and small bottle are the independent observations and from the same distribution as well, from the same normal distribution. So here we go, the mean of L minus 2S, follow carefully, large bottle minus the 2 times of small bottle. So you are going to say that whatever the mean of large bottle is, that minus the 2 times of mean of the small bottle, okay. That's how it goes, right, students? So that's what you are going to do here, okay. It's going to be the mean of the large bottle is 5.10, sir, okay. So here we go, you write down, this is 5.10, sir, minus 2 times of the mean of the small bottle, that is 2.51. So I think I'm going to get maybe a positive or a negative answer. Let's see, the 5.10 minus 2 times of 2.51. So here I go, students, I am getting this as positive 0.08 as the variance. So this is not tricky, okay. We got the variance as correct. We got the mean as correct. Correction, students. Now we are going to talk about the variance of L minus 2S, and that will have easily 2 marks, okay. Follow very carefully. Mean is simple, as we have discussed in lecture number 1 and 2 as well, that mean finding is not tricky. You just follow the linear combination of random variables. Now, variance of L minus 2S will be the variance of L. You do the variance of L plus, because minus is not there in variance, you have to square and it will become positive sign, plus the 2 square, okay. It will be the square of 2 because it's a multiple, and when we have multiple, you have to square for the variance, times the variance of small, okay, students. So variance is always going to come as positive. So here we go, variance of large is 0.0102 plus 4 times of variance of the small, that is 0.0036, students. And here we go, you are going to do this, 0.0102 plus 4 times of 0.0036, and we got the answer as 0.0246, okay. So let's check. Yes, we are getting this answer correct, that is 0.0246. So mean and variance are ready. And now you can say that y follows a normal distribution. And what is y? Y is basically that the large bottle volume of liquid in it in liters is greater than the 2 times of the volume of the small bottles. Okay, so here we go. It will be 0.08 mean, and the variance will be 0.0246. So mean is written and the variance I have written, and what we have to find is basically greater than zero. So we have to find the probability of y is going to be greater than zero. Okay, students, so we have to find the probability is at least that much. So y is greater than or equals to zero. You can say that, okay? So y, again, now it's the most simple thing that you need to understand, students, the normal distribution. Your S1 concepts will help you here. So let's just work this out as well. Here we go. The mean is, sir, 0.08, okay, students? And the value is basically zero here, okay? So let's do the value here, that the value is zero here, and you need greater answer, okay? So zero will be before something there, so which means the diagram always help you in normal distribution, okay? So here we go. We got this greater than area part we need, students. So let's work it out, the z value, and use our graph and use our MF9 table. So zero minus 0.08. And most important thing that we have, you got the variance. We need the standard deviation. So it's going to be, sir, 0.0246. So here we go, sir. The Z value is going to come, students, as what? Let's quickly do the 0 minus 0.08. So we have 0 minus 0.08 divided by square root of 0.0246. So here we go, negative 0.51, students. I am getting the Z value as negative 0.51. So here we go. How do you write this? We need the probability of Z is greater than negative 0.51. So students need to understand, you will not be able to find that. There are two things here, okay? You will not be able to find the greater than part because the graph only gives you the less than area of the MF9, okay? As well as you will not be able to find the negative value as well, negative Z value table as well. So students need to understand, because the graph gives us the left hand side values as well as it does not give you negative value. So what you have to say to the examiner is basically that I'm going to find from here the value till there. It's going to be, this is equals to probability of Z is less than 0.51, changing of the sign. So just have to look for the Z value 0.51, and that is going to be your answer, students. So here we go, 0.51, okay? So I'm getting the answer as 0.6950 to 3 decimal places. The answer is coming, sir, 0.695, okay? Hope everyone is getting it. The chapter is not difficult at all. You know the S1 concepts of normal distribution. It's not tricky. The only part that is tricky is whether it's a sum of independent observation or multiples of the independent observation, whether you have to square for the variance and add. A lot of students always forget this. They will do minus and they will not do the plus sign, okay? So this is very important thing in this chapter, and that is what concept number 3 looks like, the multiple. Definitely I'm going to solve more questions as well, so follow for more content and subscribe the channel as well, students. Thank you.